Hello there, ladies and gentlemen. RVB Shard here with another rant for you guys. A long-awaited rant, as it were. I know I haven't done one in a while, but it's been long since anything's crawled up my ass long enough to actually cause me pain when I sit down. So, I decided to tackle the subject of endgame politics, and of course, the leader of this little band of Motley Crue fucktards is of course Jack Thompson. Yes, it's been a while since I've actually paid any attention to this balding twat face, but of course, I have to take his latest shenanigans with a very large dose of salt, and perhaps a pickaxe. I am of course talking about his most recent little venture into defying games and gamers and just generally being a dickhead. I'm referring to the bill that he's trying to pass now in Utah. And I just don't comprehend this. This guy got thrown out of his own profession. He is no longer an attorney, so why the fuck is he still trying this bullshit? He's now in Utah. He went from Miami to Utah. Yes, Utah. The ass end of beyond. I mean, desert, the whole fucking Salt Lake City thing. What the fuck is that? What have they got to do with games? I mean, seriously, you tell half the people down there that Jesus wears a cape and flies amongst them, they'll fucking believe you. You know, I can't really make many comments about Utah. I've never really been there, but then again, if I did, I'd probably be tied to a stake and burned for witchcraft. But anyway, oh god, his voice is in the computer. Anyway, basically what Jack Thompson is yet again trying to do is defame the names of game developers and try and say that video games are yet again entitled to violence. No, we are not. I am a gamer. I am an angry Scotsman. I have a bit of a temper issue, and I have a very volatile personality, but I don't go around killing people. I may threaten to kill people. Doesn't mean I actually fucking do it. And video games didn't make me this way. I've been this way since school. You know what actually caused me to have this sort of temperament, this volatile nature? Was the fact that I was bullied at school. Not because I played video games. Because I was bullied. Because some dickhead thought it'd be funny to make fun of me continually for like 6 years of my life. So, yeah, that's what caused me to be an irritable son of a bitch, not video games. Maybe you should actually take a look more, Mr. Thompson, at the fucking facts and figures before you start shooting off your mouth and blaming the nearest and most recent form of fucking media entertainment. I mean, seriously, this is a genre of entertainment that people have enjoyed for years, since the 1980s, and I don't really understand why his crusade is so fixated on destroying it. I mean, when I was actually sitting there reading up some of the shit on Jack Thompson, because I do actually do research before I fucking do these things, but Jack Thompson is, you know, one of these guys who is constantly targeting games and saying, oh, they're violent video games, they're causing violence in children, you know what, I'm tired of it. I seriously don't know where his problem is coming from. Did he get his, like, ass raped at Pong or something? Was he that bad at fucking Space Invaders that he has to throw a hissy fit and throw all his toys out of his pram? I mean, seriously. I don't understand what the fuck is wrong with him. Now, think that this bill, though, is not the same as his previous ones. His previous ones claiming that all video games are wrong, that the roots of all evil and Satan is actually going to burst out of your CD when you put it on your fucking game console. But this time, he's trying to talk about the way that games are marketed to children. Games aren't fucking marketed to children. Game adverts are on TV, okay? If their parents don't want them to watch it, they should turn the fucking TV off. Or they should actually, you know, spend quality time with their children instead of plonking them in front of that and using that as a fucking automatic babysitter. You know? Oh, well, if he gets bored, I can always change channel. You know what? Fucking spend some time with your kids. Stop fucking trying to blame the media and the games because your kids turn around to be a violent little sons of bitches that want to stab you in the shins rather than spending quality time with you. I'm getting exceedingly pissed off at this. I mean, I've been a gamer for fucking years. I'm just a bit fucking sick of this guy's constant Bible humping, putting his religious beliefs as some sort of moral cricket bat that he's going to rattle people in the face with and say, yeah, you know what? God doesn't like video games. That means you're going to hell. You know, this is bullshit, okay? Violent video games do not make violent people unless they're mentally retarded enough to be influenced by fucking polygons. And I don't see why he's going after video games with such zeal when movies have been around for a hell of a lot longer and they've been a hell of a lot more violent. I mean, Christ, what's he going to do next? Cancel porn? The guy's a freaking tard. He needs to stop this shit. Or seriously, he's going to get a freaking joystick rammed up his ass. The other point that I have to go on to is the way he's talking about this marketing thing. He's basically trying to say that guys at like GameStop and whatever are actively selling these games to children. They're not. Okay? The reason these children are playing these games is because their parents are going into the store, the kid's picking out the game they want, and their parents are just dumb enough to buy it without actually reading the case. Or even if they read the case, the kid goes, I want, and starts kicking up a fucking fit. These are the same people that get Live for their 8-year-old child. Xbox Live is not for fucking 8-year-olds. If you get your kid an Xbox Live subscription and they're fucking 8, you need to be tested for mental disability. You need to be taken outside, tied to a wall, and raped by a rhino. You need to be fucking put onto a red hot car engine and have your face cooked. I mean, seriously. What sort of fucking defective person does that? You have to realize that people on Live are kind of like me. Yes, here's a good disclaimer for you. I'm the kind of fucker your kids are going to run into, and I'm going to mentally and verbally destroy them. Do not put your kids in front of me. I'm a bad role model. I will fucking kill them, and I will laugh and teabag their face. There is nothing more satisfying to me than putting my virtual crotch in some squeaky little shit's face because he can't play the game properly. Now that I've made my point very clear, I'd like to talk to these parents for a few seconds. If you seriously pick up a game and don't fucking read it or see the M label on the game, or over in this country if it says 18 or 15, you know, it's very simple mathematics. How old is your child? My child is 8. How old is this game for a 15-year-old? If you can't do simple fucking math and see that that's not the same number, then you need to be hit in the face with a shovel. A very big shovel. A big shovel that's been used for scooping up dog crap for the last 18 years. Don't fucking do this crap. I'm tired of it. I'm sick of having to run into these little fucks and then having some frickin' asshole like Jack Thompson try and stand up for them and morally use them as a weapon against video games corrupting the youth. It's not true. Video games don't corrupt the youth. Their parents corrupt them because their parents are inadequate and don't know what the fuck they're doing. Okay, the last thing I want to hit on is Jack Thompson himself. Now, not to make any, you know, personal quips and, you know, cheap groin shots about how much of a fag he fucking looks and the fact that he should, you know, be dead already and buried somewhere where a dog can quite easily piss on his open grave. But I want to actually, you know, if he ever actually watches these videos, which I doubt, because obviously he gets a lot of fucking fan mail, quote-unquote. But I actually want to ask him a few personal questions. Firstly, Mr. Thompson, why do you never fucking respond to your critics? I mean, seriously, I have made a few videos basically calling you an out-and-out bitch and poking holes in your logic, and yet you've never once responded. Why? Are you a chicken shit? Are you too pussy? Or have you just never watched my videos? Which I find rather offensive, seeing how I have more popularity than you do. Okay, secondly, what is your fucking major problem with video games? What stick have you had buried up your ass for so many years that it's now starting to pop out of your eye? Because I don't see where this is coming from. You don't seem to have any fucking true knowledge of video games. You seem to just like pick parts out of it that you don't like and then go, ah, this is a violent video game because it involves carjacking. This is a violent video game because there's dinosaurs in it. This is a violent video game because Mr. Pac-Man is eating ghosts. No, fuck you, Thompson. Okay. That's just a way of phrasing a question. And of course, thirdly, do you actually have any statistics or any figures proving that video game violence is actually correspondent in the real world to actual acts of violence or psychopathic behavior? Because last time I checked, I've looked at studies, and there has actually been very few cases where violence in the real world has directly corresponded to a violent video game. And these people, who have actually been affected by this, have been proven by psychologists to be mentally deficient, or have, you know, problems where they're very influential. Now, this is a very few scattered cases, and yet you're making such a big argument about it. So, I'd actually like to see these facts and figures that you have, that you seem to be able to claim that you have evidence of such violent acts caused by video games. So, if you'd like to, you know, send them to me, by all means go ahead and I will review them. And then if you're right, I may actually apologize. But I wouldn't hold my breath because you'll turn purple and pass out before I give a shit. Okay, well that's me, that's RV Shard, my rant's done. I'm gonna go for a cooling swim in the ocean now, because if I don't, I may have a seizure. Yeah, definitely a seizure. I'm getting heart palpitations. And that's not because I'm fat. Because I'm angry. So there. Haha. Ocean!